Hey guys, welcome to Intellipaat. This video deals with the basic concepts related to TensorFlow and Keras, because if you are interested in deep learning, then you must have the knowledge of these concepts. Let's begin then. So first of all, we are going to start it off by understanding what is TensorFlow, and then we'll be learning TensorFlow objects, followed by Keras, and then the career opportunities in this particular domain. Let's begin then. So what is TensorFlow? Now, TensorFlow is a deep learning library developed by Google in 2015 and was released as an open source platform. Now, here tensors are nothing but multi-dimensional array. And the reason behind calling it TensorFlow is that it takes input as a multi-dimensional array and processes through it. And if I talk about computational graphs, then nodes in the computational graphs represent operations and edges represent tensors. Now, why is it actually used for? So it's essentially used to generate computational graphs. Now TensorFlow is very fast because it's written in C++. But then it does not restrict itself to this particular language only. Rather, it can further be controlled or accessed by other languages, particularly by Python. Now one of the another main features of why TensorFlow is very much popular, because it's extremely versatile. It can be run on many different platforms, starting from a desktop to a cloud to your mobile devices. It can also run on CPU or on GPU, like graphics processing units. So if you want to install TensorFlow on your CPU, then you can simply use this command. And if you want to go ahead with GPU, then you can use this particular command to get it installed. So this was a very generic overview about TensorFlow, and now let's discuss the objects it has got for you. So if I talk about TensorFlow objects, then these are very essential part for TensorFlow or deep learning. Now it has got five main objects. So the first one is constants, and then we have got variables, placeholders, graphs, and finally sessions. Now let's discuss these one by one. So starting it off with the constants. So the constants for any programming language are the values of an object which remain the same throughout the program, right? I mean, that's what the generic definition of a constant. I mean, it has to be the same throughout the program. And now if I talk about variables, then they are the one which contain or which act like a container for a given data type. Now, what do I mean by for a given data type? So that means if you have, let's say, declared a variable to be an integer data type, so it can hold the value only integer values, right? I mean, you can replace the values, let's say 5 by 6, 6 by 7, but then they have to be integer only, right? They cannot be a float or a character. That is what we are saying. You have to specify the data type and then it remains the same throughout the program. Now, if you see any other programming languages, then again, the value can be changed at the execution time. And same is the case with this Python TensorFlow. Your variable again is a container for a data type. But here the only thing that you need to take care of is you must initialize the data type while declaring it, okay? Now let's go to placeholders. Now there's a slight difference between a variable and a placeholder. So a placeholder is just same as a variable, but here you do not need to declare at the initial stage, right? Now placeholder actually holds the value during the runtime. And as I said, no need to initialize the value while declaring it. Now let me tell you another difference between a variable and a placeholder. So as I told you guys that a variable is a one which has been defined by a particular data type, right? And it has to carry the same kind of value throughout the program, right? But then when it comes to a placeholder, then it can be anything. I mean, it can be a float, it can be an integer or a character. So there's no restriction of putting a similar data type kind of value in placeholder, right? That is how you allocate memory by using these particular objects. Now let's move on to graph. Now graph is the most important thing in TensorFlow because it defines the actual computation. Now let me tell you guys that it does not do any computation, nor does it hold any values. It simply defines what needs to be done, right? And then finally sessions. So it's very simple. This is basically used, or you can say the allocation of memory is taken care by the session, as simple. Right, so these were the objects that are used in TensorFlow, and it's very good, and you actually should be knowing about these if you want to go ahead in deep learning, right? And now let's move on to Keras. Now Keras plays an important role by helping to implement certain tasks. So it's generally an API, that is application program interface, written in Python. Now this is also capable of running on top of TensorFlow, CNTK or Theano. That is to say, it uses all these libraries or one of these libraries. So if you have got TensorFlow installed, you can install Keras on top of it, right? Or you can use Keras on top of it. Now, it also enables fast experimentations. Let's say, for example, if you look and try developing applications in deep learning using TensorFlow, then you need to have placeholders, constants, and many other things. And also you need to have sessions, right? But then with Keras, you are simply good to go. You just need to add layers and you are done. That's all. That is to say, by using Keras, you can simply focus on your job rather than defining the graphs, sessions, and all other stuff. And that is why it makes your task easier. Now, it also seamlessly runs on CPU or GPUs. And here I have given the command for you guys to install this. So you can simply use this particular command. This is the one, right? To get it installed on top of TensorFlow. So if you have got TensorFlow, you can simply use this command to install it. So this was a generic overview about Keras. And now let's talk about the career opportunities into this particular domain. So you can choose any of the profiles from these. Either you can be a robotic scientist, a machine learning engineer, or a data scientist. And employment here is not an issue since it's an emerging technology, and according to Gartner, AI industry could grow by $4 trillion by 2022. And if I talk about money, then again, you'll be sorted because you can earn an average salary of $143,000 per year. So you just have to be skilled and you are good to go. And now let's quickly recap on what we learned so far. So we first understood what is TensorFlow, followed by TensorFlow objects. We also looked at Keras and discussed the career opportunities for you guys into this particular domain. And after this, if you want to establish your career into this domain, then Intellipaat brings you artificial intelligence and deep learning course with TensorFlow, where you'll be taught A, how to build an artificial neural network, and then how to train the ANN using training data, TensorFlow framework for numerical computing, Keras API for working on top of TensorFlow, and testing the performance of the neural network. And with this, we come to the end of this video. If you have got any queries, simply reach out to us through any channels mentioned on the screen, and our course advisor will help you in your learning journey. I hope the video was informative for you. Please like the video, and if you have any doubts, comment below. We shall respond to it at the earliest. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more detailed information, visit our website now. Have a great day and career ahead.